One to go up top, dumps it off across the middle. Fournette.
What is going on, everybody? What is going on, everybody? What is going on, everybody? It is Treeb from Treeb Talks here for another episode of Treeb Talks.
What is going on, everybody? It is fresh haircut from Treeb Talks here. And today we are going to be going over the Jaguars starting 11 on the offensive side of the ball. And we're going to be ranking all 11 starters from worst to best, ladies and gentlemen. That is the video agenda today. We're going to go in depth on all these players, tell you what they do really well, what they need to work on, and who is the best offensive player for the Jaguars heading into the 2019 season. Now, a little programming note for you guys. I'm going to be doing this tomorrow for the defensive players, and then after that, I think we are going to be starting position outlook. So down in the comment section down below, if you can tell me what position you want me to outlook first, I will do whoever has whatever position has the most comments or whatever comment has the most likes for that position. So make sure you comment down below what position you want me to break down first, ladies and gentlemen. But for now, let's start the video. This is ranking all 11 starters for the Jacksonville Jaguars from worst to best. Number 11, AJ Can. If there's not a single person, there is not a single person on the Jacksonville Jaguars that I have continuously shat on more than AJ Can, and it's been a full 180. I remember heading into 2018 after the 2017 season, I was like, AJ Can's gonna shock you guys. It's actually a pretty good offensive lineman given the opportunity, and he just has not proved that he is gonna be that reliable guy. And it's not even that he gets injured, it's the fact that he is continuously year after year the worst player on the offensive line for the Jacksonville Jaguars, and as of right now is probably the worst player on this whole entire Jaguar offense that is starting, at least. And I don't think there's much debate as far as that category goes, and I think that it is fair putting AJ Can at number 11 on the top 11 Jaguar starters heading into the 2019 season. Number 10, Jeff Swaim. I was really irritated with the Jags, as I say every single video almost, that they did not address the tight end position a little better. I think there was better tight ends on the market that we could have picked up and could have not even got for that expensive. Like, there were some guys out there that had potential to come to Jacksonville and maybe make a difference. And, like, not even older guys, like Max Williams, a guy that the Cardinals just picked up. That would have been a decent pickup for the Jags. But they decided to get Jeff Swaim, and I guess in the grand scheme of things, it makes some sense. Because as far as the tight end that the Jags like to have, he fits that description. He's a hand in the dirt, can run block really well, and can occasionally catch a pass. But if we were going to do that, I almost would have just wanted to re-sign Mercedes Lewis, because I think that would have been the better thing to do, because we already did him so dirty. We should have been like, hey man, finish your career here, let's go out on top, let us go to the playoffs, come back and be our tight end. But instead, we decided to go with former Dallas Cowboy tight end Jeff Swaim, and I have done a little bit of film study on Mr. Swaim, and he does not have a lot of film to go off of. He doesn't make explosive plays. You know, he's no Rob Gronkowski, Travis Kelce, you know what I mean? So Nick Foles isn't going to have that tight end security blanket that he's used to having, like what he had with Zach Ertz, you know, in Philadelphia. He's not going to be getting that in Jacksonville, and Jeff Swaim needs to really show and really develop why, and he is the best tight end in the tight end room for the Jaguars, and really earn his keep at that position. Because I think Josh Oliver is way more athletic than he is and has more potential to make big plays. But as far as every down tight end, Jeff Swaim's going to be that guy. And unfortunately, I just haven't seen enough that impresses me to make me put him any higher on this list. Number 9, Jaywan Taylor. Some of you are not going to agree with this. Some of you are going to be really upset and say, Treeb, Jaywan hasn't even played a single snap yet. He hasn't played a snap for an NFL team. You can't rank him any higher. He has to be 11. No, he doesn't. Like, he's going to play better than AJ Can and Jeff Swaim, and I can almost guarantee that bucket that Jaywan Taylor is going to be a solid piece of this offensive line. I think during minicamp and during, you know, OTAs, the offseason, training camp, everything, preseason, I think Jaywan Taylor is going to be able to develop and really hone his craft, especially with the offensive line coaches that are around him, and the fact that Doug Marrone used to be an offensive line coach, and he knows how to coach up these offensive linemen. And I think with all that great coaching around him, he has no choice but to be solid. You know, a guy like Cam Robinson is kind of like Jaywan Taylor. You know, he was kind of a raw prospect that, you know, everybody thought and everybody knew he could be a really good offensive lineman. He just needed the coaching, and Cam Robinson got that coaching. And honestly, in my opinion, you know, he went down last year, so he didn't really have an opportunity to show it, but he's one of the best left tackles in the league, and that is all from the coaching that the Jaguars have offered him. And I think it's going to be very similar to Jaywan Taylor. You know, we're going to have two guys that are setting the edge that we drafted and that we have developed. And I think that really speaks volumes to this Jaguars coaching staff that they are able to do that with these young offensive linemen, especially at the tackle position, because it's not easy to develop those kind of guys. And I think Jaywan Taylor is going to come into his own, and I expect him to be a little higher on this list by the time the season ends. But as of right now, since he has not played a snap, I think number 9 is fair, and that is where Jaywan Taylor lands on this list. Number 8, Chris Conley. Chris Conley has a lot of potential to explode in 2019. Him and Nick Foles already have that chemistry that they need to have in order for that duo to be very, very successful. However, you know, you got a couple of wide receivers that are going to be above him in the depth chart, like D.D. Westbrook and Marquise Lee, who we'll talk about in a little bit. They are also in this video, obviously. And Chris Conley is going to be kind of slotted in as the slot receiver or the number 3 guy for the Jags. And I think that's where he should be, and I think that's where he has his best opportunity to shine, is where he's not the number 1 guy, which he shouldn't be by any means. And, you know, he could be a reliable slot wide receiver for Nick Foles, who, again, has chemistry with him already, and I think he could explode. You know, he's a speedy guy that once he takes the top off the defense, if Foles can hit him deep, goodbye. That kid is gone. He is very, very fast. Speed is the name of his game, and I'm very excited to see what Chris Conley can do for the Jags. But again, he hasn't played a snap for the Jags yet, so we can't rank him too high. But I am very optimistic about what Chris Conley can do for this Jaguar offense in 2019. Number 7, Marquise Lee. Now, Marquise Lee is obviously the longest tenured Jaguar on this offense, except for Nick Foles, but he is the longest tenured Jaguar on the team. He's been on the team longer than anybody. I think the only person that matches him is Brandon Linder. And those two were drafted in the same draft class, if I recall right. I'm about 100% sure they were. So, you know, Marquise Lee has been a good security blanket. He does what he does well. He's coming off an Achilles injury, and usually that either makes or breaks wide receivers. Usually after injury, they're either completely irrelevant, never to be heard of again, or they bounce back in a big way. And I'm really hoping Marquise Lee can bounce back in a big way. And I think having a guy like Nick Foles as your quarterback, I think that's going to develop Marquise Lee as a player. Because he never really had a top-notch elite quarterback. You know, he had Blake Bortles for his whole entire career, and now he has a quarterback that's a lot of bit, more competent than Blake Bortles. So I think his game is going to improve, and I think, you know, he's put in the work during his Achilles injury. If you follow him on Instagram, you know, you see the hard work that he's been doing to really come along and make sure that he is healthy for the upcoming season, and I think he will be healthy, and I think he will be reliable. Marquise Lee is known for getting injured, though, whether that be a long-term injury or just a little nagging injuries, so I'm not expecting him to be on the field at all times, but I'm expecting for when he's on the field to be pretty impressive and to be reliable. But again, he is not one of the top-tier guys on this offense. That is pretty mediocre all around, but I think he has the potential to kind of reach his old form and to be able to be a successful target for Nick Foles in this offense. Number 6, Andrew Norwell. We made Andrew Norwell the highest paid guard during the 2018 offseason, and he got hurt, but it's not like he played bad football when he was in there. He just didn't really play as the same player, you know what I mean? And he was hurt, and this whole offensive line was just decimated. But you can't knock the guy. He's a former All-Pro. He just got dealt a bad hand in Jacksonville his first year here. And I think now that everybody is healthy and he's filled in and he should stay healthy for all this season, hopefully we're relying on it, then I think he's going to ball out this year, and I think he's going to be doing a good job keeping Nick Foles standing upright. He's a speedster guard as well. He can pull and get around and make sure that, you know, on the toss plays, that the edge is sealed, that he goes out and gets the corner. He's nasty. He goes out there. He gets after it. He's probably pound for pound the best offensive lineman that we have, but I think there's a couple other guys that are going to outshine him in 2019, but he is definitely a solid piece to this puzzle, and he's definitely going to be a great piece to this offensive line in 2019. Number 5, Cam Robinson. Now, I'm a little bit of a nerd because I am so excited to see Cam Robinson bounce back from his injury in 2019 to come out and show why he is one of the elite left tackles in the NFL. This guy's a bruiser. You know, he's good at sealing the edge, making sure, you know, the pass rusher isn't getting upfield, making sure that he's not stretching the play out. Cam Robinson does everything that an elite left tackle should do, and this is only his third year in the league. His first year in at 2017, he did spectacular. I think he only gave up 2 sacks that year. And then in 2018, he had another good season, but unfortunately, he got hurt and could not play for the rest of the season. But in 2019, if we get a whole year of a healthy Cam Robinson, he is going to be locking down these elite pass rushers, and you guys are going to see the man that Cam Robinson is. And Cam Robinson is one of the best left tackles in the league, and I think he's going to go down as one of the always going to be up there. You know, when you talk about the best left tackles in the league, you have to talk about Cam Robinson. I think that's the kind of player he's going to be. He's going to develop to be an elite player at his position, and he is one of my favorite players on this Jaguars team and one of the most elite players on this Jags team. However, he's not the best offensive lineman that the Jags have, because that belongs to one other man who's been doing it consistently year in and year out. But as far as the ceiling goes, Cam Robinson is going to be one of our best players for a lot of years to come if he can stay healthy. Number 4, D.D. Westbrook. From the moment the Jaguars drafted D.D. Westbrook, the Heisman finalist, his last year in college, everybody was kind of expecting him to go off. And his first year, he had some sprinkle moments. You know, he was out there, he was making plays after the catch. You know, he had that punt return touchdown. You know, there was a lot of things D.D. did well in his first season that it looked like he was going to translate well in 2018, and it did. He was Blake Bortles' favorite target last year after the Marquise Lee injury, and he stepped up in a big, big way. He made a lot of big boy NFL catches. You know, I will never forget, it was the Philadelphia game. He caught a pass right in the back of the end zone, tapped his feet in. That's a touchdown. This guy is the best wide receiver the Jags have heading into 2019, and this is a wide receiver room that mostly is underproven. And I think that they are going to be able to show their skills and prove what they have. And D.D. Westbrook is a guy that I think Nick Foles is going to rely on a lot in the deep game and in the mid game. I think Marquise Lee is going to be more of the security blanket, but on 3rd and 5, I think Nick Foles is going to be looking in the direction of D.D. Westbrook, because I think he has the most for sure hands. He had the least amount of drops out of any Jaguar receiver last year. He was the most reliable. He led the Jags in receiving yards, and there's no reason he shouldn't do it again. And I think, dare I say it, he might be a 1,000-yard receiver, the first 1,000-yard receiver for the Jaguars since 2015, and I hope his name is D.D. Westbrook, and I really hope D.D. translates his game well again in year number 3, and he develops into a top-notch wide receiver. Number 3, Nick Foles. We don't have to spend a lot of time talking about Nick Foles, because everything we could ever say about him has already been said. I have talked about Nick Foles probably more than I've talked about anybody, at least during the offseason. You know, it's been about Nick Foles for a long, long time. Even during the season, you know, late in the season, Nick Foles and the Jags were connected, and we were already talking about it, talking about how it was a bad idea. And now that he's kind of in Jacksonville and we've kind of accepted the fact, and, you know, you kind of step back, you look at the tape and see what he's done now that he has some experience in the league. And that's another thing that I don't like about what people are saying about Nick Foles. You know, the people that think that he's not going to be a good quarterback for us is because they look at his older tape. Let's not look at his older tape. Let's look at his most recent tape. He has dominated, he's a Super Bowl MVP, and he has played well. He's peaking right now. He's 29, 30 years old, and he has all this experience. He has a Super Bowl MVP under his belt. What more do you want? Like, this is a guy that is hitting his stride right now in his career. And if you look at all of his bad tape with the Rams, so who is his coach? Jeff fucking Fisher. Jeff Fisher is the worst coach in NFL history that's not named Gus Bradley, and thank God Gus Bradley is not coaching this team, because we would definitely be in trouble with Nick Foles. But with Doug Marrone and John De Filippo, who Nick Foles knows, and bringing in a guy like Chris Conley, who he already has that chemistry with, there's no reason Nick Foles should not succeed in this system here in Jacksonville, and he's definitely going to be a key contributor for the Jags in 2019, and he's going to show how much a real franchise quarterback goes. It goes a long way. Have the Jags found their next franchise quarterback? I don't know. We can't really say until we see him play, but if he plays well, then oh my God, guys, we have a franchise quarterback. But if not, ooh, it might be tank for Tua season in 2019. because we need a quarterback that can win us a game now, because we have it built. For the most part, we have it built. We just need a guy that can take us to the promised land, and hopefully that is the third best player on this offense, Nick Foles. Big Dick Nick. Big Dick Nick. Flood the whole comment section with position outlooks you want me to do and Big Dick Nick. Number two, Brandon Linder. Brandon Linder, pound for pound, is the best offensive lineman the Jags have, and I'm glad the Jags took a chance on him in the later rounds in 2014 because he has been a monster for us. We gave him that big payday. He ended up being the highest paid center in the league until I think it was the Steelers extended Marquise Pouncey, and then he became the highest paid center in the league. But, you know, for a time that was Brandon Linder, and Linder deserved every bit of that contract. And he got hurt last year, like this whole offensive line did, so I'm not going to use that as a big excuse as to why he should be higher on this list, you know, maybe like in the 4-5 range, and maybe, you know, in your guys' opinion, he's not the best offensive lineman we have. Maybe you think it's Cam Robinson or Andrew Norwell, but it's Brandon Linder, who has been a solid piece of this offensive line, even when it was garbage. You know, when this was a terrible offensive line in 2014 on, till 2016, you know, his first 2 years, he was the best player we had on this offensive line, and the fact that he continues to be a leader at the center position and to be the best offensive lineman that we have for so long, even after we have already brought a lot of pieces to the puzzle, is very, very impressive. And I'm very happy to have Brandon Linder on this team because he's one of the best centers in the league, and he's definitely the best offensive lineman that the Jags have. And number one, it's Leonard Fournette. Leonard Fournette is the best player the Jags have on this offense, and he has proved it time and time again. In 2017, he's proved it. 2018, he had some games where he proved it, and he had some games where he didn't prove it. But that was because the Jags were so damn one-dimensional in 2018, because Blake could not throw a pass to save his entire life. But now that they have Nick Foles throwing the ball, and that you have to worry about a guy that's actually a natural throw of the football, that opens up the hole and opens up the gate for Leonard Fournette to have a monster season in 2019. Now, I know every fantasy football expert across the globe will tell you to avoid Leonard Fournette this year, but I'm telling you this, draft Leonard Fournette. Even if Leonard Fournette is not going to be a Jaguar for his whole entire career, he needs this tape to prove why he deserves a big payday by another NFL team somewhere else. He needs to perform, because no one's going to give him money now from the, you know, the tape that they have seen. Yeah, he had a flashy 2017 season. 2018, he fucking got hurt, didn't even try, and, you know, the last game of the season, he was sitting there with his arms crossed with TJ Yeldon. You know, like, he is a personal problem. But if he can get all of that stuff settled, get all of that shit out of the way, Leonard Fournette is one of the best, if not the best, yes, I said it, running back in the NFL. He has potential to be that guy. He has speed. He has downhill running ability. But it just seems like the Jags always draft these head cases and they don't know how to fix them. They need to find a way to get Leonard Fournette motivated in 2019, because if he is going good and if he is playing well, this Jaguar team is going to be very, very hard to stop in 2019. If their best offensive player shows up, this offense is going to run wild, and you know this defense is going to lock down these other offenses, and the Jags are going to be a problem in 2019. And that was ranking every single offensive starter for the Jaguars from worst to best. What did you guys think? Leave your comments down below. Don't forget, you check links down below as well. You can like me on Facebook at Treeb Talks. Follow me on Twitter at Treeb Talks. Or follow me on Instagram at Trey Vaughn Pixley. Also, if you haven't yet, hit that subscribe button. Click the bell icon to get notified every single time I drop a new video. I drop new content on this channel 6 days a week. Ain't nobody outworking me. Them's are just straight facts. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. And as always, you guys have a terrific rest of your day.